I teach regular chemistry to 10th grade, advanced chemistry to 11th and 12th.
I teach elementary school, 4th, 5th, and 6th. All subjects.
I teach 11th and 12th grade chemistry.
I am a 9th grade teacher for an honors physics class and an intro to physics and chemistry.
I am a culinary teacher, so I teach pretty much all grades.
11th grade chemistry as well as 11th grade biotechnology.
This course provides a different viewpoint, a way to get kids more excited. All of these fun processes, all of these fun treats that you can create in your own kitchen, they all involve chemistry, and we're all going to learn about these processes together in the classroom.
The workshop is incredibly fun. It has given me a new perspective on how I want to teach chemistry, because it's something that they all do. They all like food, they all eat. Most of them actually cook for themselves, so they can actually relate to the cooking piece of it and then see the chemistry in it.
It's a lot of hands-on work. It gives you a chance to be the student, but also really connects to like your work back in the classroom, so it feels really useful.
I can implement a lot of some of the things that we've done, even though it was a week, but it was a very well-impact week. It was really engaging.
Chunks of the big chemistry content and how you can really take that and break it down into very high engaging and accessible learning for students of all levels is something that I am very excited to be able to take back to my school and to my students, so that I can let them know that chemistry, which can sometimes come with connotations of difficulty for kids, to show them a way in which it's around them all the time and it's very accessible, and it can maybe even start to have them think critically about the things that they do in their life outside of school.
There were like such a fascinating ways like to learn how to involve science through cooking.
When I think of food chemistry, it's very complex, and there's a lot of reactions that go on that are maybe something you can understand, but how to distill it down to a student is very challenging. But that this course really does break down the fundamentals to what is something you want to accomplish, and also something that they see every day more than maybe the typical lab.
It gave me more confidence to teach more in-depth science when doing cooking activities with my students. I think I have more confidence that I can speak knowledgeably and introduce problems to them. I've been thinking about how to make cooking and science more investigatory for them. I love the tinkering, and I can totally see the appeal for my students.
Kate's content really worked well at taking the big ideas and breaking them down into bite-sized pieces.
And I do like the way that she thought about us being children, still learning different concepts in different ways, in different styles. She taught in almost all of the styles, whether you were on a spectrum or not, whether you had a learning disability or not, whether you were autistic or not. So that was, I think that was one of my major concerns, was how would you break this down on every single spectrum? And she did that.
I thought I was going to know all of the science behind everything, and that was certainly not the case. Making boba, I did not know that I could use that as a way to teach ionic bonding. And that's a great topic for my teacher toolkit that I can take with me moving forward.
I think even the comparison of like baking soda, baking powder, I've known the difference. I've kind of done something in my class before, but really seeing truly how they are different through our investigations, I think was something that I didn't quite get before.
Let me think about how can I do ricotta as I've done it before, but teaching it in a whole different manner. So, because what she did, I'm taking it. I'm just telling you, I'm stealing it, so.
And then you can see all the different connections that you didn't think of. You get to network with other people and learn new things from other people as well.
I loved having the opportunity to network with other teachers who might have some similar student demographics and similar challenges, and being able to bounce ideas off of other people, because it's always really good to be able to take a content or a way that you would maybe approach teaching a certain area of your content, and then hearing from others about how to maybe expand it or how to make it more engaging and a richer opportunity for your students. So that was a huge takeaway, being able to have a new network of teachers that are not necessarily local to me, but also will be a really good sounding board as we all try to take this information back and implement it into our classrooms.
I really enjoyed the boba when we did the modeling, and then the whole getting together and figuring out, like, okay, how would you produce this as a model? What does the model look like? And then getting really down to the whole nitty gritty of showing that you have the balanced equation and how things rearrange and that they don't necessarily disappear. So that one actually had many different levels that it could show the kids ions, it could show the kids ionic compounds, and it could also show the kids like a double replacement reaction, and how everything in a double replacement reaction works, and how you have the equal number on both sides of the equation.
The great thing about all the different labs is that, like, I am a more of a chemistry teacher, and yet I could see some of the bio teachers seeing links to everything we were doing as well, and different ages. So I teach high school, and yet here's this Montessori elementary school teacher being like, yep, I can do that too. And I think that's rare, that you get the same concept that you can like span over the whole K-12 education. That was kind of cool, especially like imagine a school system where that same lesson could be taught over and over again, and they're just layering on that knowledge. Like, that's what we want, and that was really cool that it can potentially happen.
I cannot stress enough how engaging in the bite-sized pieces of what this content has done to be able to help see very complex ideas broken down into very simplistic chunks of information for students. And it's going to make things for my student population be so much more accessible to them. I cannot recommend this enough.